just to show you a point. It's an old video, but I think it's still relevant.
Part of your brain with the fight or flight mode has started waking up.
and now you're feeding him or her caffeine, which is not a good thing at all. Then your senses are overloaded even more, so you need to travel or commute to work. So it's either by sitting in traffic, dropping off the kids at school. If you're using public transport, it's not very less, that sensory overload, because you still have people there in your space and in your face. All of the noise around you, I think in my mind, I've never been in a taxi, but in my mind, I think a taxi is even worse than the other means of public transport. And then, of course, especially if you're using like the car train, the unnatural lights in the train is all things that is making the sensory input even harder on you. Then I've noticed that some people will start their day by having a look, attending to their emails. So you've woken up, you've already started to look at your emails, look at your notifications, you've been stuck now in traffic or public transport. There's no time to breathe because now you're looking at your other notifications, mail, WhatsApps, Facebook, whatever the case might be. So if I add, and I've seen in my personal capacity, if I do that and I add another cup of coffee because I'm feeling tired, it's a whole cup of crazy that's going on in my head. And the worst is that people expect you to come to work and be focused and all productive. If you tell people that, you know, now I'm feeling a little bit anxious or a little bit overwhelmed, some people will even advise you to go and take deep breaths somewhere quiet. And in the building, there's not many spaces. So I've tried and experimented with that. I've sat in my car to try and find that peace and quiet, which doesn't happen. I've tried to do it in the toilets as well, and it doesn't happen because there are some other noises there as well. So to get to the essence of this, this talk is not going to be on how to find inner peace, because I don't know how to do it. This is about recognizing that there's a lot of sensory input from the morning, from the moment that you get up, and then people expect you to focus, and you haven't dealt yet with that sensory input. All our senses get overwhelmed by all of the sensory input, but what I will be showing you is some of the signs or symptoms, and then also what part of the sensory input is being addressed, and what exercises and quick fixes you can do to get your focus back. So some of the signs is that you get to work, you're a little bit irritable, you shut down, you refuse to participate in activities. I see it especially with the stand-up meetings with some of the people, especially if they come in very late in the mornings. They don't really feel like participating, and then us coaches think, oh, maybe they don't understand the concept of being a team and the stand-ups. You have difficulty focusing on an activity. You're constantly changing activities. You sometimes have trouble with those social interactions. Now, I know myself as well. If I've had a difficult morning, when I get to the office, the last thing I want to do is interact with people. I want to sit there, be left in my corner, and be left alone. In fact, I want to sit and rock myself like this. And I don't get the opportunity to do that. So you will also see some people are restless, they're fidgeting, and difficulty concentrating. So I've had a colleague once, and I didn't understand it up until recently. He always sat like this behind his desk, in the mornings especially, and he did this. And I always thought maybe he was having a party in his head or something, but it's not that. He was busy trying to find his balance again. Because it's a big word, it's called the vestibular system, which is in your ears. With all of your other sensory systems, they're trying to find the balance again. It has to do with all of those fight and flight hormones in you to try and find that balance. Okay, so there's a couple of strategies for self-regulation that you can do. And I've broken it up into the whole body sensory tools. So it's starting with a little bit more expensive tools, then less expensive, then even less expensive, and then if an occupational therapist could have a way. And I'll show you some of the toys in the toolbox here, and I'll give you an opportunity to play with it as well. But if we look at the whole body sensory tools, it's that deep pressure massage. So some of the companies are already doing it. Don't do it to one another, because it's called sexual harassment. But it does have a way of calming you down. If you're really interested, you can go and have a look. There's some pressure points here on your palms that you can press. That can also help to calm you down. If you sit in a meeting and you're feeling distracted or anxious a little bit, especially in the mornings because you haven't had the opportunity yet to get your focus, you can rub your hands on your lap like this. It will also help. The other thing that you can do is just with your fingers tap here on your wrists. It also manages to calm you down. Yes. Weighted bean bags. So at the physiotherapist, I don't know if any of you have been at a physiotherapist for some neck therapy before. They've got those lovely bean bags which you can warm in the microwave. So you can actually put it on your shoulders. And what that does is it simulates that deep pressure as well with the heat. It makes you feel safe. So if that is not an option for you, you're feeling really, really distracted or anxious, ask someone to give you a big hug. It will have the same effect. Then, this one is quite fun. I haven't done it yet, but spinning on an office chair, because it balances again, you know, that inner ear, all of the fluids that need to be balanced there. So don't do it too long. Research has shown that if you do it for 15 minutes, then it has the effect, a long-lasting effect of 6 to 8 hours where you will feel balanced and focused again. So remember with this, with the inner ear, if you do it the one way, you need to do it the other way as well, otherwise you will feel out of whack. So do it perhaps 7 minutes on the one side and then 7 minutes on the other side. You might get dizzy, yes. The other one is, like I said, the pressure point. There's a tent on there, so you'll see, or if you do research, Google has that effect of the tree houses, which is a little bit more enclosed. It has to do with the fact that you get stimulated by all of those lights, because all of your senses do get overstimulated. You can actually climb into one of those small pop-up tents, zip it closed, have some earphones in there. In fact, if you really feel that you need to get some work done, take your laptop with you to the pop-up tent. To the tent, yes. Google also has slides. You must have seen the slides when they slide down. And I thought it was just for fun. It's not. If you slide down, it releases a hormone called dopamine, which enables you to concentrate again. So you can have a run as well, but then you might be sweating. Weighted blanket is also, it is a blanket with some weights in. It is a little bit more expensive, so, you know, if you, the alternative or good alternative is the weighted beanbags, and then you get compression clothing. So some of us ladies know those compression clothing, where it makes your tummy smaller, and it pushes up the things where it needs to be pushed up. That also has a great effect on keeping you calm and having your focus. Then with some of the smaller sensory items, there's the clay, and I've always wondered about the clay. So any normal clay, just by playing with it, because you press it, you let energy go, somewhere it cannot return. So it's a good way to push all of that, those frustrations away. It also enables you to become more creative. I've seen it recently where I facilitated an assessment with a team, and I said, hey guys, I really want you to participate, don't be on your phone, play with it, play. You can do anything you want with it. Usually the guys just roll it in their hands, and this specific team decided to build something that is rated 18. So I said, you're no longer allowed to play with it, play. But it does enable you to become very, very creative. There's another product called Loop. It's a little bit harder. I'll send it around, but then you can press it. You can buy it in the children's store, and you can feel the difference between the glue and the clay. You just open this up. So I have to warn you though, don't get this on your clothes. Some of the parents might know this, but it is a little bit harder compared to the clay to press. So if you're really, really stressed, use the glue. Interesting fact about this is that they also use it with patients who's had neck and spinal injuries to try and get that fine motor skills back again. You can just send that, pass that now. This is also an interesting toy. It costs $25 at a pharmacy, similar to a stress ball, but it has that effect if you press it, then the resistance doesn't push back. So it's a very relaxing thing. You can have your kids make their own with a balloon with those little, I think they call it sea monkeys, put it in there. And you should ask your teens to play with it. The other thing is these little rubber bands. Give a bunch of teams a bunch of rubber bands to play with, because this also tends to be very relaxing. Let's set that down. Everyone knows the fidget spinners. A good alternative for play is the press stick. I don't know if you've seen people play with press stick, because it's also nice and like that. I think, you know, if you really want to make people work a little bit, put in some resistance bands, because they're putting against their own natural body weight. You can have them do plank exercises as well, or squats. Just to get that energy flowing. Adult coloring books. I know it's a big thing at the moment, but it really tends to bring you to focus. Then the sweet spot thing is, and this is interesting, so I also wanted to share or to send this round, and then I'll tell you, take one and then just send it round. So stickers always get people to focus, and the reason for that is your thumb needs to do a couple of things while you are busy either sucking or chewing on a stick. Now, if someone is really, really, really anxious, really in a bad spot, give that person a hard sweet, because sucking on that basically reminds them of when they were babies. So that sucking really relaxes them again. So the sucking sweet brings focus because it makes them calm. But don't only give them hard candies, because otherwise they'll be so calm and focused that we won't get any participation. You also need to give them something that's chewable as well. Because if you chew something, you get energized, your brain starts working as well. It's because of the tongue movement, because it's going from left to right and all the way around, awakening all of your senses. So I've seen and I've experimented a little bit. The sour worms, has brought me the most joy when I've handed those out to the teams. Also, dumb. It's a good thing to bring people to focus. What I don't like about gum is that people just keep on chewing all the time. That's a certain personal preference of mine. You can have them with a little bit of ice. Distract them before you start your meeting with a game or two. You know, maybe a little silly game before you bring them to focus. And there's also something called the 5-second rule, where after you've done this, you can say, okay, you know, I'm going to count backwards to one, and then we're going to be focused. You know, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, we're focusing. So, I asked the occupational therapist, her name is Mirena, and her surname is unpronounceable, but I'll show you her surname. If she had all the money in the world to come and assist me with the teams to help me create focus for them, what are some of the toys that she would bring? So, one of the big things is a Pilates ball. And I asked her, you know, but the guys are already sitting, some of them on it, and then they're jumping on it sometimes, or even balancing, trying to see how far they can balance before they fall over. She said it's exactly that because, you know, the inner ears is trying to balance itself out with all of the senses. I explained to her what a stand-up is, and she said, well, in order to have a very focused, productive stand-up, you need to have other people jumping on the trampoline while they're doing stand-ups, or sitting on the Pilates balls and jumping. The slides was the other thing as well, as I mentioned before. If everyone goes down the slide before they have some sort of a meeting, we'll have very focused people. Swings also. I challenge you during the week to come, go and get on a swing sometime or another, because that back and forth rocking really brings you focus and makes you calm as well. Another thing that people can do, and maybe that's why you need the tent, is when you do that back and forth rocking with a song, then you also get your focus back. But it might look weird if you just sit there and do this, if you're concerned about looking weird. Or you can do it all together with row, row, row your boat. Row, row, then. Do it together. Trampolines, like I said, and an alternative to that rocking might be a rocking chair in the office. And then also stringing beads. That's also a great tool for bringing people together. And that is my very short talk. I would like to thank you, and I would like to give you a special mention to my son's occupational therapist. Her name is Marina Rosenstroch. I hope that's the way that you pronounce it. And a registered nurse, Annelie Klaassen, because they have provided me with a lot of information over the past 2 years and I'm able to do in order to present it to you. Yes.
No, I was just thinking internally, because I'm looking at all these strategies that are well and good, and I've done some of them, not even aware that they really, really fast calm me down. But some of us come from small organizations where you have your top senior person who will walk in, just randomly walks in, and then when you do that, sometimes they look. I'm just saying, how do you manage that? Maybe this needs to be introduced at that senior level so that they understand that sometimes the teams, they need to take, not all at the same time, one person. If you find me swinging my chair,
or the whole team, bro.
It mustn't be an interpretation that you are not working, but you do need that. And I feel that organizations, especially, I'm coming from a bigger corporate where that was fine, it's not an issue, but in a small organization, you get those random walk-ins and then you pretend as if you are working, even if you're not focusing. You have to, because you have to show that I am actually working, but that's not good.
Yes, yes. So perhaps that is the thing, to go and show this. And I'm sure that the slides will be made available on the Agile Africa somewhere. Go and show the slides. Myself and the occupational therapist Marina will be more than happy enough to assist you so that you can go and present this to your management level. So that they realize you're not weird. You're just trying to find your balance.
Not going more weird. You're actually just refocusing.
Yes. Any other questions or comments? Okay, I'm sorry it was so short, but thank you for your time. I hope you can use some of the strategies.